to my house.
It's my house.
11 in the nation by 30 points, Coach.
Well, that, that must tell you that Gonzaga is pretty darn good because we know Redding's outstanding.
Yeah, and we're here in Hazleton's back home now. And like I said, they captured the Allentown tournament during the week, beating Woodson, Virginia in double overtime, 65-62. Sammy Guzman, a big game, I believe 17 or 18 points in that game, and then beating Bethlehem Liberty, 55-53. And Coach, as you said, living on the edge there, those close games. They lost a heartbreaker at the beginning of the year to Allentown Duriff by 1 point, but we're not going out on a limb saying this team can be 6-1.
Absolutely. And again, you know, we were here, as you said, we saw them against Whitehall. They had a chance to win that game with no time left on the clock.
Yeah.
So, hey, you know, what could be and what is are two different things. However, it's good to see that they've been competitive in every one of their games, with the exception of that one. And now we start conference play tonight, I believe.
Yes.
Tokanek Tigers team comes in.
And Tokanek has a big team. We don't have any of their heights here from their roster, but just looking down at him from center court, you know, Ben Chilson is a 1,000-point scorer, also the quarterback of the football team. He's the leading scorer on his team, Coach. He averages 20 points a game, and Dylan Matus at 17.5 is the second-leading scorer. The last game they played, they lost to a 10-1 Northwest team, 58-54. Shane Macko led the way with 17 points. So they're getting it done with different players on this team, and this is a senior-led team for Coach Shane Lunger.
Yeah, Spencer Lunger comes in.
Spencer, I'm sorry.
That's all right. The sixth year at the helm, a Tunkhannock graduate, an 06 Tunkhannock graduate. 11-12 last season, 5-9 in the Wyoming Valley Conference Division I. And, you know, as you mentioned, Chilson scored his 1,000th point, and Matus is right there with him, as he's been a high scorer a couple other games as well. So, you know, we should have a good one tonight.
Well, one thing for Tunkhannock is they like to stroke the ball from behind the arc. Dylan Matus, 21 three-pointers. Ben Chilson, 17. By my Hazleton math, as I say, Coach, that's 38 three-pointers from behind the arc. Hazleton comes out. They like to play that zone. If they have to bring that zone out, we'll see if Tunkhannock has the advantage inside. But Joey Marshall and Chris Catrone at 6'3 and 6'4 are keys to this game on the glass for the Cougars.
Absolutely. They're going to have to neutralize the triumvirate of Matus, 17.5, Chilson, 20, and Macko, 10 points a game. They're the big three for the Tigers.
But like I said, our starting lineup here is all seniors.
Agreed?
For Tunkhannock, the last game, I got a shout out from the Duke already. He's listening in the dungeon. Shout out to the Duke. And give a shout out to the Duke coach. He was our scorekeeper down in Williamsport earlier in the week for the Christmas tournament. Did a great job.
Well, I heard so much about the Duke. Finally got a chance to meet him.
You weren't there last night for Watergate.
No, I was not, but I kept abreast by pictures and tales of stories of lore. Nice man, good man. Everybody I've met here so far has been tremendous, above and beyond nice. Anything you ask for, they help you, and it's awesome working in a place that cares.
Absolutely, and we're going to take a break here for the anthem.
Officials and spectators can and are expected to assist in the promotion and achievement of good sportsmanship by taking personal responsibility for keeping this contest at a high level of fair, clean, and wholesome competition. We ask that you remember that the purpose of this activity is to provide positive learning experiences and opportunities for personal growth for the participants. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the video board for a message from Dr. Brian Uplinger, Superintendent of Schools in the Hazleton Area School District.
Hi, everyone. This is Dr. Brian Uplinger, Superintendent of Schools for the Hazleton Area School District. I want to take this opportunity to thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting our students all across the district, from academics to athletics to extracurricular and everything in between. Thank you so much for being here. At this time, please rise for the playing of our national anthem and also our school alma mater. Let's go, Cougars.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the
twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming.
Everybody, we are back here at Hazel Area. Nobody doesn't like Hazel Area. They dim the lights, coach, and now we're going to have.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's meet starting five for the Tigers from Titanic High School. He's a 6'1 senior, number one, Shane Macko.
Shane Macko.
5'9 senior, number two, is Nick
Tigers, 72% free throw shooter.
Nick DeMarco getting to start tonight.
He's a 6'5 senior. Where's number five, Ben Chilson?
And there's the heart and soul of the team, Ben Chilson.
6'1 senior, number 11, Garrett Uhas.
Garrett Uhas averaging 5.5.
And a 6'3 senior, number 14, Dylan Matus.
And Dylan Matus,
the Tigers
we talked
are coached
about him.
By Spencer Lunger.
We don't have heights for the Tigers, but. They got three trees at least out there.
Yeah, I see a couple redwoods. And now your Hazleton area Cougars. We got music pumped in here at all, coach.
You got it, that's right.
And now, the starting lineup for your Hazleton area Cougars. F-R-5-9 junior, number 15, Luke Gennaro.
Luke Gennaro.
Edgar, 5'11 junior, number 21, Sammy Guzman.
Sammy Guzman had a great
week. And forward, a 6'3 senior, number 35, Chris Cottrell. At forward, a 6'4 junior, number 44, Joey Marshall. At center, a 6'4 sophomore, number 20, Sterling Mianciano. The Cougars are coached by Tim Barletta. He is assisted by J.J. Ryan Miller and Jimmy McDermott. The officials for tonight's game, Joe Zielinski, Howard Walker, and Kevin Keyes.
Time to play the game. And we're set for the opening tip here. And Joey Marshall is going to jump with Ben Chilson. And we're underway here from Hazel area. Trip control told by the Tigers. That's Matus. As he gets the ball over to DeMarco, we have a pushing foul. Here we go. Here's Macko across the timeline. Picks up his dribble. Being guarded closely by Guzman. Matus for three. Off the back iron. No good. And a rebound by Guzman. Here comes Gennaro. On that left wing between his legs. Kicks it over to Catrone. Messiano trying to get position inside. Now back over to Marshall. Marshall swings it back over to Gennaro. 7:26 to go. Just underway here. First quarter. Being guarded closely by Macko. Cougars looking for a good shot. That patented offense, they move the ball around, coach, a lot.
That they do. They want to look for the good shot. And they'll be patient to run 2 minutes off.
Guzman has that blocked by Matus and into the hands of Juhas. And here comes Mako. Mako drives off the window a little hard. And Messiano brings the rebound down. Runs down to loose ball. Ball tipped away again. Sloppy play here to start the game the first minute. And Howie Walker's going to call a walk on that. And the Duke would know because the Duke is listening. I believe that Howie Walker played basketball in the area here. I remember a Howie Walker that played for the Foot Stompers. I think that might be him. That's the Duke. Good man.
Two possessions, two open shots for the Tigers.
Over to Chilson. Chilson, 1,000-point scorer here for the Tigers. Drives to the lane, no good by Matus, and a rebound by Marshall. And here comes Gennaro. Swings it over. Guzman had a good look at the three there. Drives, baseline hangs in the air. Once again, hands in the passing lane. Here comes Mako. Mako, a game-high 17 points on Monday night against Northwest. Gets up in the air, can't get it to fall. Ball tipped around like a volleyball.
Yeah, he tried to get tip it back to the backcourt, but he hit it way too hard and it's out of bounds. Cougars are going to get the ball with another possession.
No score here.
Tankanics had some good opportunities to start the game.
Left-handed dribble, Gennaro across the timeline. Over to Guzman. Picks the ball up over his head. Chest-high pass over to Catrone. Swings it back over to Gennaro. Three ball on the way. That's no good. Rebound, Messiano underneath. And gets it off the window, up and in.
Yeah, Starling doing a nice job there battling on the boards to get those 2 points to get Hazleton the lead.
Mako with the ball. Swings it back over to Matus. Get a spot up for three. No, missed everything there.
Yeah, he's 0 for 2 from the same spot. That's unusual. If you're a Cougars fan, let's hope that continues.
Gennaro. From the elbow, now back out to Guzman. 5:25 to go in the first quarter. Marshall flashes in the lane, kicks it back out. Gennaro's going to launch a three. No good again. Rebound by the Tigers.
It bounced
and that
and
was
out.
Nick DeMarco pulled that one down.
Shortest kid on the court got the rebound.
Mako over to Chilson. Being bodied up there by Catrone. Down low to Mako. Kicks it back. Juhas drives to the basket. And that was swatted away again. Here comes the Cougars in transition, and ball will go out of play here with 4:50 to go in the first quarter.
And Matus did a nice job of anticipating the pass lane there. And one thing we've noticed again so far with Tunkhannock, one and done. Hazleton's did a nice job on the glass so far.
And Gennaro swings it back over to Catrone to get to Marshall on the block. Joey trapped there, kicks it back out. Sammy thought about a three. Messiano fills the lane and back out to Guzman. Three ball on the way. That is short. Cougars not shooting the ball well at all from the outside in the early going.
Now both teams are cold from the outer limits.
Matus over to DeMarco. Back over to Dylan. Dylan, a senior, 6'3". And back out to Mako. A lot of height there in the backcourt for Tunkhannock.
There is.
Over to Juhas. Good defense by the Cougars. 4 minutes to go. Rapid moving quarter. Chilson spots up for three. That comes in and out. Gennaro with the rebound.
Paul, I was just about to say, you haven't heard anything from Chilson so far. And then he got his first shot and was off.
Catrone for three. Got
there
it.
There we go. Nothing but net. Chris.
Spotted up, got a good look, and knocked it down. Cougars lead 5-0. Nice hustle by Catrone on the defensive end. Chilson will trigger to inbound here. Over to Mako, back over to Ben. On that right wing extended now, ball held high above his head. High pass over to Chilson, being guarded by Catrone. As they swing it over to Matus, he'll let a three go, and that got stuck in the corner.
He's 0 for 3, Paul, with some good looks to start the game. Three good looks from the three-point line. He's 0 for.
Yeah, both teams not shooting the ball well from the outside, but Hazel has the lead, and we're almost 5 minutes into the quarter here. And it's 5-0. Tigers still haven't scored. Gennaro across the timeline. And this is a big game for both teams, as he was talking about, Coach, just starting conference play.
Conference opener, you're correct.
Patron picks up his dribble. Has it stolen by Macko. 2-1-2 break.
Nice hands and a good outlet pass.
Luciano again, missed the bunny. Catrone at the doorstep, can't get it to fall. 3 for a buck and it goes in.
The second time. Hazleton's dominating on the glass offensively.
And the Duke just confirmed my statement on Howie Walker. Went to GAR, one of the best guards in the Valley.
So, Paul, if somebody would have said to you with 2:28 left to go in the first quarter of this game, Tunkhannock would be scoreless,
what would your thoughts have been? An extra point.
Yeah, exactly. But they are ice cold from the outside, and they haven't really gotten anything other than a layup early on attempt that was missed.
Well, I mean, you can't get it. There's not such thing as a 7-point play. So you got to score first and build from there. The good part, if you're a Tunkhannock fan, is Hazleton hasn't been shooting the ball well either. And this could be a lot worse. Macko picks up his dribble, being harassed by Guzman. Over to Chilson. It's really all over Ben.
Hazleton's doing a nice job of switching off, which isn't allowing Tunkhannock to get the shots they want when they're setting the screens.
We missed that substitution, Coach. Caden Madden into the ballgame for the Tigers. Patron for three, and Matus put that in the second row.
He would have none of that.
.151 to go, first quarter. Cougars lead 7-0. Gennaro, left-handed dribble now over to the right. Chest-high pass over to Santiago into the ballgame also. Coach Barletta substitute early. Santiago drives, kicks it back out. Gennaro spots up for three. Can't get it to fall. That looked good from up here, Coach.
Yeah, it looked good, and he stepped back to make it a three.
Tigers got number. Juhas out the window, up and in.
Yeah, nice pass.
Nice running the floor by Garrett. And you watch, they filled the lanes, Coach, laid it up and in. 1:22 to go. Tunkhannock got their first basket, and they needed it. Oh, from elbow, can't get it to fall is Gennaro, and another rebound by Matus.
Yeah, an excellent shot.
He has a bunch here, Coach, already.
He came off the curl screen. He had a beautiful open shot, just missed it.
Chilson can't get it to fall, hangs off the rim. Cougars got a 3-on-2 break if they hurry. Tunkhannock trying to get back. Santiago underneath, gets him off his feet, can't get it to fall.
Oh.
And a rebound by Juhas.
I think he expected a foul.
Well, they're letting him play here. Chilson spots up for three. That looks good.
There we go.
That's money there.
Yeah, you don't want him warming up, Paul Bowe. And just like that, it's a 7-5 game.
5-0 run by the Tigers as we're closing out the first quarter. 27 seconds to go. Cougars with the ball going from right to left on your screen. Over to Guzman. Sammy right-handed dribble, chest-high pass over to Catrone. Right wing extended. Back to the top of the key to Marshall. Near the volleyball spike line out there, Coach. They're really running that offense high up. And over to Gennaro. Gennaro almost lost the ball there. Here comes the double team, throws it away to Juhas. Tigers have numbers again. 3-on-2 break, and there's your horn. One quarter in the books here from Hazleton. Cougars lead 7-5. Let's take a break, and we'll be right back.
serenading us in the background as we're ready to start the second quarter. Your Hazleton Cougars 7, Tunkhannock Tigers 5.
All right, we are back here at Hazleton area. Coach, last game of 2022.
That is correct. Where did the year go? Man, it just seems like yesterday we were standing out in the football field in our short sleeve shirts. That's not happening tonight. Although,
even though it's very nice outside tonight.
Correct.
Here comes Macko, 7-5 quarter in favor of the Cougars. Over to Juhas, hands it back over to Shane. Shane picks up his dribble, high pass over to Matus. And back over to Chilson. Chilson trying to get him free there. Over to Juhas. Fights his way off, gets to the rack, can't get it to fall. Three Cougars under there. And they're going to get a foul on Madden, I think, with an elbow. Unless they called it on Hazleton.
I thought Madden had the elbow, but apparently they did not. They are going to call it on Hazleton.
Three fouls on the Cougars. None on the Tigers so far. A little backdoor cut. And he threw it away.
Yeah, he threw it Nolan Ryan style at about 90 miles an hour. Paul, are you surprised that Tunkhannock's not trying to post up anybody in the paint with the height advantage that they have overall?
Well, from what I can see here in the first quarter, Tunkhannock's guards like to play outside. They're not playing underneath. That backcourt likes to be around the three-point line, much like Hazleton. Patron drives, one-hander, no good. Three-on-two break again for the Tigers. Here comes Madden. Taps the brakes, no walk. Four-on-two for the Cougars if they hurry. Santiago to Guzman. Off the window, can't get it to fall, and he'll shoot a pair.
That he will, and he was close to traveling as well, I thought.
A lot of frequent flyer miles today, Coach.
This is correct. But, as they say, it's not a foul if it's not called.
Well, right? The game we did the other night down in Williamsport, Teaneck, New Jersey, had a 6'8" kid who's going to be D1. Tyler Tejada, he was lights out, and he was fouled about every time he had the ball. And he still scored 25. First one is no good.
Anciano checks back in for the Cougars.
No good by Guzman. Second one, no good. Rebound.
Had it
comes
initially.
Down in the hands of Macko. And Macko slowly walking the ball up the court. Right-handed dribble being guarded by Guzman. And over to Matus. Macko down low, tries to pass it around.
Bounce off Starling's leg. Still beat Tunkhannock ball. Now they posted up down low that time. So we shall see. But you are correct. They like to hang out around that three-point line.
Yeah, they're more shooters than they are going to post up here. And I'm surprised with Macko running the point, they don't post them up there. Chilson for three.
There he goes again. Oh, boy, man. He's smooth. It's easy to see why he's as good as he is.
Give him six. He averages 20. Tigers have their first lead by a point. They're on an 8-0 run, Coach.
Yeah, Hazleton's gone ice cold offensively.
Santiago, top of the key, back over to Starling. Back over to Catrone. Gennaro pops for three. That's off the back iron. And Matus clears the carom.
Yeah, as you said, their shooting percentage, they're having a hard time tonight from the outside, Paul.
Chilson again pops the three, in and out. Two Cougars there, pulls down a rebound. It's Miniciano. And it's over to Gennaro, left hand now over to the right, picks up his dribble, chest high pass, over to Santiago, drives baseline, throws it in reverse off the window, up and in. Nice move by Nikolai Santiago.
Yeah, it was a good first step off the dribble to get that up and end the scoring drought for the Cougars.
They needed that bucket in a big way. 9-8 Cougars, 5:21 here to go in the second quarter. Here's a steal by Gennaro. Gennaro taking it right at Macko, now swings it back. Catrone thought about popping a three. Oh, Messiano fills the lane. And they're going to call a jump ball, and it will stay here with the Cougars as Joey Marshall checks back into the ballgame.
Yeah, I think a Starling wanted to shoot it before he caught it.
5:07 to go here in the half. Low scoring, Coach.
That it is.
Now, Tunkhannock hasn't scored a lot of points either this season. Nice move by Gennaro. Clears space out and gets it up and in.
Yeah, a little head fake there to get the trees up in the air, and then he was able to put it in. And 2 points tonight for Luke.
First bucket of the game, 3-point Cougar lead. Gilson again pops up for three. A lot of contact, no call. Cougars looking to run. Guzman. Oh, boy! Matus put that off the doors.
And that's twos for Matus tonight in terms of blocks. And they've been emphatic ones at that.
Santiago drives right down Broad Street there. Rugby
hustle.
Scrum on the floor again, and that's going to be Tunkhannock ball.
Yeah, excellent hustle by both teams here as they're playing hard. They're just not shooting the ball well, especially for Hazleton. If they start nailing some of their outside shots, they're going to be dandy here tonight, but they're struggling at the moment.
4-3 quarter in favor of Hazleton as we're halfway through the second quarter. Coach Barletta getting his miles on there, walking up and down, pacing the sidelines.
Well, Gennaro does a nice job of fronting people up and forcing people to pick up their dribble away from the basket.
Macko, nice move over to Juhas. Matus spots up, that's short. Starling, another rebound.
I believe he's 0 for 4, Paul.
And he leads the team with 21 three-pointers coming into the game. He is short. When that's you're short on the ball like that, it's usually tired legs, but we're only in the second quarter. Gennaro to Marshall. Marshall backs his way in. Nice move by Joey. Gets the roll up and in.
Good physical move in the low post, able to get the easy points.
Give him 4 for the game. Cougars lead by 5. There's an offensive foul right there.
Yeah, nice.
Coach, you saw right there, Matus thought about the three-pointer, but when you're 0-for, trust me, a guy who shoots a lot.
Well, you take one of two schools there. You either get gun-shy or you do the opposite and load the rifle and keep firing away and hope you shoot yourself out of the slump.
He was a little shy on that one.
He was gun-shy there. You're absolutely correct.
Cougars by 5. Marshall.
Let's see Joey get a little physical tonight underneath. I'd like to see that. No?
Yeah, absolutely. Control drives, changes directions in the air, and 1.
Nice job.
Nice take by Control. And the Cougars now by 7. And now they're on a 7-0 run here, Coach.
That's
8-0 run.
Let's complete this 3-point play.
Control will go to the line shooting 64%. Made the big foul shot to put the game in overtime against Whitehall a couple weeks ago. And Control knocks it down. He got 6 for the ball game. Cougars have doubled him up, 16-8. 3 minutes, 13 seconds to go in the half. Here comes Ergot. Over to Juhas. Nice backdoor cut. Thrown away. Marshall comes down with a loose ball. Into the hands of Santiago. 2:55 to go here in the half. Over to Marshall. Marshall back over to Control. Control, mid-range jumper, high arcing, can't get it to fall. Ball batted around again. Into the hands of Macko. Here comes Shane. 2:41 to go. 8-point Cougar lead. Back over to Juhas. Spots up for 3. Nobody under the basket, but all Cougars. And it comes into the hands of Guzman. Guzman over to Santiago. Across the timeline. Bounce pass down low for Marshall and a little too hot to handle.
Yeah, bounced off of Tiger.
Bounced off Madden's hands. Cougar's going to trigger under the basket. Is Control. Over to Marshall. Back to the basket. Back over to Chris. Drives. Taps the brakes. Ducks under. Can't get it to fall. Rebounded by Madden. Here come the Tigers. Chilson, long cross-court pass. 3 ball on the way is no good by Ergot. And 2 minutes to go here in the half.
Catrone's going to walk it up the court.
9-3 quarter in favor of the Cougars.
Or Gennaro, excuse me. Only got him for a double dribble. Coach not real happy with that.
No. Well, listen, this has not been a picture-perfect half for either team.
Kind of expected a little bit more scoring, Paul.
Yeah. 30-second timeout here by Tunkhannock. Let's take a quick break. We'll be back. 1:53 to go in the half.
Next game for the Cougars is coming up next Wednesday right here at Hazleton Area High School. And the opponent will be the Berwick Bulldogs. Again, that game is next Wednesday evening right here. Cougars versus the Berwick Bulldogs.
Welcome back to Hazleton Area. 1:53 to go before intermission. 16-8. Cougars lead. And Mackle brings the ball up. Tigers going from left to right on your screen. See Guzman overplaying him. Mackle had 17 the other night. Has not scored yet, I don't believe.
Nope.
And another shot comes off the iron.
0 for 4 for the floor from him and one foul, Paul.
Gennaro, right wing back over to Guzman. Catrone, chest high pass to Marshall, lets a three ball go and buried it.
A nice job off the screen. He had a 3-point play and he was assertive, took it, knocked it home.
Marshall has a game high 7. Cougars by 11. Chilson can't get it to fall. Excuse me, that was Mako. Can't get it to fall. We're under a minute to go.
Hazleton can afford to be very patient here, work for the shot that they want.
They're running the clock down, 45 seconds to go.
With an 11-point lead.
Over to Gennaro, 30 seconds to go, clock moving. You probably see them getting their offense with about 10 seconds to go. Marshall having it way outside, back over to Gennaro, 20 seconds. Over to Marshall, here we go, 12 seconds to go in the half, 10 seconds. Back over to Gennaro, Gennaro drives down, hangs in the air, and he'll go to the line to shoot a pair.
Great patience by the Cougars to get what they wanted.
And Luke will go to the line to shoot a pair, shooting 88%, Coach, for the year.
I like my chances with him on the line, Paul Bowe.
First one up, and first one is good. As they say, Coach, he massages the nylon.
Surprised Hazleton's not pulling some people back a little bit further with 5 seconds left.
And the second one is good. 3 seconds. Mako swings it back, throws it away at the horn, and we are at the half. Hazleton Area with a 14-point second quarter. Outscores Tunkhannock 14-3. They lead 21-8 at the half. We'll be back here to Hazleton Area.
For shooters 18 years of age and under. Halftime shootout sponsored by the Beer Barn and Booties. If you make a shot, you win a ticket for some free slice of pizza.
You should be rolling with me, you should be rolling with me. You're a real life fantasy, you're a real life fantasy. But you're moving so carefully, let's start living dangerously. Talk to me, baby. I'm rolling up on this sweet, sweet baby. Whoa. Let's lose our minds and go crazy, crazy. Ay, 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 ay. Keep on hoping we'll eat cake by the ocean.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you have a 50-50 ticket, please check your number at this time. Winning number four of the 50-50 drawing, 497-902. Once again, 497-902. Last call on the 50-50, 497-902. And if you have the winning number, you can claim your prize right here at the scorer's table.
Waste time with the masterpiece, waste time with the masterpiece. You should be rolling with me, you should be rolling with me. You're a real life fantasy, you're a real life fantasy. But you're moving so carefully, let's start living dangerously.
Keep on.
Gymnasium has the best music, bar none, as Paul Bowe's up here
shaking his money maker.
And that's enough for me, folks. Coaches turning it in for the evening.
Well, we'll be going later if anybody wants to join us. Coach, why do you invite the public at the Tap House? Coach will be out at the Tap House. Paul Bowe will be out at the Tap House. Go and see Ostrich Hat play afterwards. Come see us, buy us a Coke or a meal. We're hungry, right? Jeez. Hey, we'll take whatever we get here. I wish we had a camera on us up here. I'm eating gummy bears.
Camera on you, right?
And
we're getting ready to start the third quarter. Cougars curiously in front, 21-8.
Marshall, a game-high 7 points. For the Cougars, Chilson has 6 of the 8 for the Tigers. Cougars going from left to right on your screen. That's Gennaro. Right-handed dribble now switches over to the left. Back over to Guzman. Left wing extended. Over to Catrone. Inside to Marshall at the elbow. Has it taken away by Juhas. And into the hands of Matus. And so
Joey wasn't real aggressive there with the ball, with that pass, Paul. He needs to protect the ball with more urgency.
Macko. Over to DeMarco. All 5 starters and... That just hit a pedestrian walking into the gymnasium.
You know what else I just noticed, Paul? Not many fouls called in this game.
And that's a good thing, Coach.
Well.
We've seen enough in the last couple of weeks to last me the rest of 2023 that didn't even start yet. Over to Marshall, swings it over to Guzman. Good ball movement by the Cougars. Catrone high, arcing 3. No good. Rebound, Marshall underneath, and Chilson... They're going to call a push here. Soon a foul's on. Chilson had all ball, it looked like to me, Coach.
I think it might be on him, though.
It's going to be on Chilson, yep. And you talk about good foul shooters. Joey's shooting 86%.
And nice, again, I'll mention it again, good to see him being physical underneath the basket.
Yep. Well, Coach... One thing we always have to say when we do basketball games, for the last how many years, good teams are usually good foul shooters.
Correct.
Hazleton is a very good foul shooting team, and good teams, with good foul shooting, win close games. I just jinxed them. 22-8 Cougars lead. Here comes Macko. He's been scoreless tonight. Over to Matus. Matus back to Juhas. Trying to get the ball to Chilson. And swings it back to Macko. Macko drives, kicks back out. DeMarco.
Oh, excellent defense.
And by Guzman there.
Yeah, Sammy got all ball. Possession arrow now favors Tunkhannock, but it'll flip over to Hazleton for later on.
And Macko's going to trigger the inbound here. Just underway here, third quarter, 1 minute, 11 seconds in. Cougars leading 22-8. Macko launches the three, can't get it to fall. They've hit 2 3-pointers the whole game, and both by Chilson. Guzman over to Gennaro. Drone pulls up for three, and that rims in, out, and back in again.
Nice job by Chris there with 9 points tonight.
Now he has a game-high 9. All from behind the arc, Coach, I believe.
I believe you're correct.
No, he had a three. He had a three-point play the old-fashioned way. Hit a foul shot.
Still a three.
It's still a three. Macko from the elbow kicks it back. Long tray on the way. Hard off the back iron and into the hands of East Starling.
One and done again for Tunkhannock as their shooting woes continue.
Yeah, they're down by 17 here. Gerald drives baseline right by everybody, and he'll go to the line as...
I think they're going to get DeMarco with the push, the body.
Substitution coming into the game here for the Tigers. Did not catch his number yet as he's at the scorer's table.
We'll get him, Paul, as soon as he stands up. He's all crunched up over there.
Gennaro, as we said, 88%. First one up, and first one is good. Ethan Ergot coming into the game, number 12. 26. Gennaro's second one on the way is good also. Macko crossed the timeline and there's a poke there. Swings it back over. Ergot long three, got it. They finally got one to fall, Coach.
They did, and they've been few and far between tonight for the Tigers.
They've scored 5 points in the last 11 minutes, Coach. That's not, you're not going to win many games like that.
No, not when you're shooting the ball the way they are tonight. And I'm noticing, you know, it might be a feast or famine year for them. If they're on, they're on, and if they're off, they're off.
Well, they played a very good Scranton prep team tough. They beat the Shamrocks and Trinity, who were always a strong team, out of District 3, and Control takes it to the rack, and Chris has 11. So this team could score, but some nights just aren't your night, and tonight the outside shooting is not there. And they're going to get
Guzman
with the body. And that'll be the first team foul on Hazleton for the second half.
Starling's going to have a seat.
And Guzman into the hands of Macko, off the window, up and in. Good to see Shane on the board.
And this is not what Hazleton wants here. They have command of the game. They don't need to be sloppy. They can afford to work their offense and get the shots they want. They don't have to be in a hurry.
Drone can't get the fall, gets his own rebound. Back out to Gerald Marshall for three. Got it.
Wow. Nice touch from Joey. He's got 11, I believe, for the evening.
Yep, give him 11.
And he and Chris Catrone, two high scores for the Cougars tonight.
Yep, 22 of the 32 Cougar points. Chilson's been quiet. He hasn't taken a shot here in the second half.
Now he had those 2 3-pointers, and then he's sort of fallen off the face of the
earth. He really hasn't touched the ball, Coach. They're really not giving him the ball. Matus short again, and a rebound by Marshall. Excuse me, Catrone. Over to Guzman.
Yeah,
and one.
Nice job of Sammy running the floor, and good job with the outlet pass to Sam, and we may get a T here.
I think the tech T's on Guzman.
I think so as well. I don't know what he did.
Yep.
Did you see anything?
He obviously said something.
Yeah, he must have said something. I didn't see any demonstrative actions.
Duncanic's going to call a timeout here also. All right, let's settle things down here. Let's take a quick break, and we'll be back to Hazelton area. We're back here at Hazelton area. We had a foul. We have a technical.
So, to the best that we can gather, Sammy must have said something. So he's going to shoot his foul shot to complete the three-point play, possibly.
Correct.
And then we'll go to the other end of the court where Tunkhannock will shoot their technical foul shot.
All right. Now Chilson's going to shoot, and Chilson is shooting 90% from the line.
Who knows tonight?
19 of 21 for the season.
I think he's had three shots the entire night. He's made 2 3-pointers.
First one up, first one good.
That's his first point since the first quarter, I believe.
Correct. Yep. Oh, second one around the rim and out. It will be Tunkhannock ball.
One of those nights when you're 90% free throw shooter and 1,000-point scorer has...
I mean, what an athlete Ben is, though. Quarterback of a football team and a bunch of these guys. Uhas plays football, I know that. A wide receiver for the team. And Tunkhannock has a nice squad. Football team didn't have a good year this year, but they're building. A 2-for-3, long one. Can't get it to fall at all. And Control pulls on a rebound. 3:35 to go in the third quarter. Cougars by 21. And that is going to be Tunkhannock ball.
Yeah, 3:27 left here. The last thing you want to do if you're the Cougars is give Tunkhannock any hope and any type of momentum heading into the final quarter.
And the Cougars have scored 14 points in this quarter. That's more than they've scored in the first two. Over to Chilson. Chilson just being harassed.
He's out of sorts.
Three is partially blocked into the hands of Marshall. And Gennaro will walk it up the court. Into Marshall, kicks it back over to Santiago. Santiago drives, and he is fouled.
It might be on Macko underneath.
What I'm noticing on Tunkhannock is when Hazelton does drive to the basket, no one is stepping up to help.
No. Their help defense doesn't appear to be very strong. They're getting no rotation from anybody coming over there. If Hazelton can get around them, which they have tonight a couple of times, it's an easy two-point basket. Astute observation, Paul Bowe.
Santiago at the line, 60% for the season. First one is hard, and that is no good. Substitution in the game for the Tigers is number 31, Dayton Kandrovi. Why do you leave me with all those hard names, Coach?
Because you're the hometown guy.
There goes our hometown guy for three. And here comes Chilson. They got numbers, 4-on-2. Cougars trying to get back, and Macko has his pocket picked by Gennaro.
Nice job by Luke there, too.
And we'll stay here with the Tigers. 2:37 to go. Cougars by 21. Long three for Chilson around the rim. Three on two break, four on two now for the Cougars as they join numbers. Misiano up and misses the bunny there. Can't get it to fall.
A wonderful no-look pass to set him up.
Matus pulls it down from the corner. Ergot, that's his second one.
Man, Ergot's going to end up being one of the leading point scorers for the Tigers tonight. Who'd have thunk it?
Yeah,
more than Matus.
He got two good looks.
And Chilson dished them off twice to him, I believe. He didn't even look to try and shoot the ball.
No. And Seattle up, down underneath, and you know what? You're seeing these Starling playing a lot more minutes tonight. They're going bigger inside. And he's 6'4", and he's only a sophomore coach.
And he looks confident tonight.
Very confident. Matus has not scored tonight at all. Macko backs his way in, and it's slapped away. And
they're going to get a foul there, but there were three Cougars around the ball instantaneously. Totally different than what we see on the other end of the court with Tunkhannock.
Just odd that the official farthest away called that foul.
It often is. And Starling's going to have a seat. Sammy Guzman back into the game after having a nice conversation with Coach Barletta, which I'm sure dealt with the technical.
Sammy's a good kid, though. That's very uncharacteristic of him. Chilson yo-yoing with the ball out there, Coach. Kicks it back over.
Yeah, and I mean, they're not setting anything up for him to even try and get him any shots.
There's a steal by Santiago. Lays it up and in.
Nice job. And I think the Tigers can feel this one starting to slip away here with a minute to go in the third quarter. Nice dish off.
Chilson gets a bucket underneath.
As you stated earlier, that's not his game. He'd rather be out the three-point line.
Gennaro on that left wing being guarded by Macko, overplaying him. Back to Santiago. We're under a minute to go here in the third quarter. There's that lead
nice
offense
weave.
There. Gennaro trying to get through and has it taken away. Catrone into Marshall underneath and they're going to get him on the arm.
Is that Chilson I think they're going to get? I believe it is, Paul.
Yep, number five. I'm still in awe of this scoreboard trying to see where they're putting the fouls for each foul. What a beautiful, beautiful scoreboard here at Hazel Mary.
Yeah, all three of them. The one in the middle, the largest. Just impressive facility.
Marshall will go to the line.
Yeah, we were commenting when we just did the Top Hat tournament, how nice it was there. But
yeah.
It's nice. I'm sorry.
We got to find Skyler. He was supposed to put that thing all the way up for us, Bobby. He's in trouble. Skyler, he was supposed to put that thing all the way up. He told me he would take care of it. He got sidetracked taking the garbage out. He's down there in the corner. I can see him. Talking to Mr. Omalecki down there.
Is there anybody here you don't know? You're the hometown guy.
Yeah, I guess. 26 seconds to go here as we wind it down. In the third quarter, another
turnover.
Turnover. Three on one for the Cougars. Tigers trying to get back. Gennaro, nice head fake, drives baseline, goes right around them, up and in.
Real nice hesitation.
10 seconds to go in the quarter. Gennaro almost picks his pocket again, and it's going to stay here with the Tigers with 5 seconds to go.
Well, he's relentless.
Hazleton with a 23-point quarter, Coach. Really blew this game open.
Yep, they have.
5 seconds to go. Chilson long, NBA range three. And three quarters in the books.
Quarter, Hazleton,
44-19. Let's take a break.
19.
We'll be back.
Quarter.
All right, welcome back here. Fourth quarter action here. 44-19, Cougars big. And there's a foul by Kondrovi. Here, like I said, and next week they'll play Berwick.
January 4th, they will be playing the Berwick Bulldogs back here at McGinn.
And the girls will be playing on Thursday nights. It'll be a Wednesday-Thursday back-to-back one up here.
And I believe the Lady Cougars will be taking on the Pittston area Patriots, who are having a very nice season.
They're unbeaten as of the other day. I don't know if they updated it all, but they were undefeated. The Lady Cougars suffered a loss yesterday, and let's just hope Lacey Kringy was okay. I was told that she had an injury and had to be helped off, and let's say a prayer, and hopefully it's not the worst, and she could be back on the court soon. And
yeah, you hate to see that happen to any participant from any school, so hopefully she will be able to be healthy and continue her season. She plays so hard.
Long three by Matus there. Cougars with a three-on-two break. Santiago running the show. Catrone pops out long three. Can't get it to fall, and a rebound by Ergot there. Smallest guy in the court. Pulls it down up ahead to Chilson. A nice move by Chilson to the rack, up and in. You can just see Ben Chilson, the athletic ability. They kept him in check, though.
Correct. They've done a very good job tonight with him and Matus.
Catrone drives, hangs in the air. Good block by Matus there. Doing it on the defense end. Up ahead to Chilson. Taps the brakes, lays it in off the window, up and in.
Good timeout here by Coach. I think he wants to get everybody refocused
timeout
down the stretch here.
Hazleton.
6:41 to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
And ladies and gentlemen, t-shirts are about to be thrown by the Hazleton cheerleaders. Are you ready for some t-shirts?
Here at Hazleton area, a little Crocodile Rock, Coach playing in our headphones, and the Cougars are rocking here as they're up by 23 with 6:36 to go. And Catrone comes free underneath. And
nice pass by Marshall.
Good look by Joey, and Cougars hitting on all cylinders here. They're up by 25.
Off the Chilson.
Just threw it away. He tried to get it to Chilson. I don't think he was expecting it.
Nope.
Gennaro drives to the basket. He is fouled. And that'll be the 17th foul.
And I think they got Matus, who has not had one of his better evenings tonight.
No, and for averaging 17.5 points a game, has not scored tonight at all. Still out there hustling, though. Dylan will hustle all night long.
Hey, there's people that play all during the week in the NBA that make millions of dollars that have bad nights, so he'll rebound.
Johansson Moran coming into the ballgame. Saw him play a little bit in the JV game. Ninth grade, Coach, 6'3". There's only one senior even on this Hazleton area team, and that's Chris Catrone. So Coach Barletta, I mean, the future is bright here for these Cougars.
Agreed. And as you stated earlier, very easily could be 7-1 right now.
Yep. As Gennaro comes free.
They're just running They're running to court now on them.
Yeah, you're going to see some wholesale substitutions for both teams very, very soon. Comes Gennaro, picks up his dribble, hands it over to Moran. Back to Santiago. Chest high pass back to Gennaro. He's going to launch a three, and he's got it. Luke's been on fire in the second half. Give him 15, coach. And most of them were in the second half.
Matches his jersey number for the evening.
Matches his points per game also. Average. Long pass up ahead. Kandrovi with the interception. And Gennaro backward. Three on none break. Catron. They want him to ram it home, coach. I was getting ready for flight 35 to take off.
Yeah, I think he was in between there. I think he wanted to, but got himself under the basket too much and laid it in instead of...
DeMarco being harassed there.
Instead of dunking the ball. Another miss tonight. I believe that was Mateus again, correct? Or Matus again?
Matus, yes. Over to Gennaro, right wing now, back over to Santiago. Oh, DeMarco just took an elbow right in the face,
yeah,
inadvertently.
And an inadvertent one is correct.
Let's hope that Nick is okay. And a good show of sportsmanship by Santiago to make sure he's okay. Went over and shook his hand. And now we have a line change.
Two games, two hockey references. What's up with you?
Well, this is a full line change, coach. Xavier Brown into the game, the X-Man. Who else into the game here? We have Moran. We also have...
Sammy's back out on the court. Nikolai's on the court.
Unfortunately, coach, number 50 for Hazen tonight, do not have him on our roster.
As I don't either. He's not
I apologize.
Listening.
But he's big, I can tell you that. Another big fella. He's trying to post up down low. Santiago and pass down low. A nice move by Guzman. Can't get it to fall. 3:32 to go.
Yeah, Sammy did everything right except for put the ball in the basket.
And they're going to call a timeout for some more substitutions. We'll take a quick break. Listen to some music. And here we go. That was a quick timeout, coach. We're back. That wasn't even 30 seconds.
No.
I didn't even get a swig of water there.
No.
Logan Miller into the ballgame. We got a bunch of substitutions there. Berkheimer, I see in there. Oh, we go. He's Starling up ahead, and he's going to lay it up and in. Excuse me, that is Moran. And it's been all Cougars.
Coach Barletta emptying on the bench.
2:48 to go. And we're going to have a whistle, and it's going to stay here with the Tigers. Cougars by 33. And the clock will continue to run here. Ezekiel Henley coming into the ballgame. Headley with the ball. Swings it over to Brown. Elijah Rojas also into the game. Nice move by the big fella. Baseline, can't get it to fall.
Yeah, it just bounced off the rim, but it was right there for him. 59-26, Paul. And coach has got to be happy with this victory tonight.
Less than 2 minutes to go here. Into the hands of Logan Miller. Now back out to Moore. We saw Moore playing the JV game. Good-looking freshman.
Correct.
About 6'5". And this night just wasn't the Tigers' night tonight.
Now, Hazleton had something to do with that, too. They were aggressive. They really never let Chilson get into the game, and Matus never really got into the game. He had two open shots to start the game within the first minute and a half. Didn't make them, and it was all downhill from there for him.
Androvi?
Yep. Senior.
Tunkhannock led 8-7 at one time, and Hazleton scored 52 of the next. And Tunkhannock had 21 points. They outscored him the next series there. So Headley with the ball now picks it back up. Over to big fella. Over to Moran. I think Hazel's going to try to dribble this out. Moran inside. Throws it up underneath, and he is fouled.
Turn that. I have it muted here. You can keep talking to him if you want.
Now the clock should stop.
Get on. Walk down with that. Yeah. Walk down with that.
21 seconds to go. And coach is going to go down and try to get a word with Coach Barlett after the game. So first one up, and first one is no good. Second one up is off the back iron and rebounded by Moore. 20 seconds to go. Back over to Moore, 11 seconds to go. Shot no good. And a rebound, and Hazleton is going to dribble it out. And the Cougars are going to win this one by 30. Going away. And we're going to send it down. Coach, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Okay, we're going to send it down to Coach.
I'm going to try and get Coach. Coach Barletta, can I get a word with you when you're done shaking hands? Thank you.
All right, they're going to go shake hands here, and Coach is on the baseline there. Coach, I wish you were like Aaron Andrews down there, but unfortunately, you don't look the same.
Well, thanks, Paul. I appreciate that greatly. I've lost a little weight. I got my hair cut. I'm trying to do good, and now you just hammer me in your hometown here, nonetheless.
That's all right, Coach. We're going to send it down to coaches. He's going to get catch up with Coach Timmy Barletta of the Cougars.
All right. Coach, first of all, congratulations. It is. Is it on?
Yes.
We can all hear. Yep.
So, look at that guy up there.
Well, he told me to say that he sent me down here. So this is the first time we've ever met. So I'm Coach Zalonis. We're doing the games. And what a great effort tonight. You did a great job shutting down their three-headed monster. Did you do anything special?
Yeah, we played defense. Listen, we were determined coming in. We went out this year and tried to find the hardest exhibition schedule we could find. And the whole plan was to play the best we can and get better, to get ready for our league. And we just went down to Allentown this week, and we fought our heads off to win the Allen tournament, and we were all excited, and I said, let's not get too excited. We did all this to get ready for the league. So our exhibition schedule has gotten us better and better, and we were fired up tonight to come in because a lot of people picked us third, and they picked Dallas and Tunkhannock in our league ahead of us. And with all due respect, they're all good teams. Our division's as good as it's ever been.
Mm-hmm.
But we wanted to prove a point tonight. Yeah, we might be 4-3, but look who we're playing, and we're gonna be ready for the league. But we talked. I don't want to say too much about what we did on defense because we played them again.
Well, no, but I'll tell you, outside of Reading, you could very easily be 7-1 right now.
Yeah, we could be 7-1. There's no question about it. But I said we could have been 6-1 or 1-6. That's how our schedule was. But this was a more convincing win. This feels good. But we're getting better, and we're going to keep working. We're going to celebrate this one tonight and get back to work.
Nice to see Joey being a little bit more aggressive underneath the basket tonight. He had a couple of good physical plays.
Yes, and he's going to continue to get that way. And Chris Catrone and Starling is going to play more and more. He started the year only on JVs, similar to Joey Marshall last year. And we're a bigger, stronger team with Starling, and we're going to keep working with him too.
And you're young.
We have one senior.
Yep.
But we're a work in progress. We're going to keep getting better.
All right, Coach. Thank you so
thank
much.
You. Happy New Year.
Same
tell
to
those
you.
Guys up there. I love them.
They can all hear you. All right. Thank you, Coach.
Coach, tell Kiko good teams win good close games.
He's gone.
He's gone.
So we'll send it back up to you, Paul.
All right. Hey, it's a final score here. The Cougars 59, Tunkhannock 29. And as Coach said, and he caught up with Coach Barletta, it was all about defense and that Cougar offense as they shot lights out. I believe Luke Gennaro was the leading scorer with 15 points on the game. So until next week, I believe we're back here on Wednesday when the Berwick Bulldogs come to town. Thursday, the girls will play the Lady Patriots from Pittston, who are undefeated as last reported. Coach coming back up here and get a word from him quick, and then we will turn it over and we'll be out of here. All right, I'm back joined up here by Coach.
Always leave that on and just talk from there, buddy. Go ahead, put that tight.
Coach is fiddling with his headset here. And
well, I'm just getting used to, now that we've got everything. I'm not used to this technology, to be honest with you.
Hey, I'm glad you ran down those steps to get Coach Barletta there. What a treat.
Oh, no.
What a
treat. Oh, no. No, don't try and dig in now. You made your Aaron Andrews comment. Don't try and dig out of the hole, buddy.
I told you, he's a real treat to interview here, much like Coach Gavio.
What a great, those two coaches have been awesome. They give you great interviews. They're cordial, win or lose. And I wanted to say something, we were on the air, but he took Sammy to the end of the bench and sat next to him and talked to him for a good minute or so about that situation. No theatrics, no yelling and screaming, no stomping. And to me personally, that's the sign of a good coach.
Absolutely. And Sammy's a good kid. I know Sammy.
Absolutely.
And I know the family since Little League. That's very much not like him. And hey, heat in a moment in the games, things happen, but you live and you learn. And like I said to you, Coach, before he left, good teams find a way to win close games. Tonight, there was no close game. He's right. They came out fired up. They play a tough exhibition schedule. They're going later in the month down to Reading to play in the Reading shootout. Teams from all over are going to be in that thing. Not sure who they're playing yet, but it doesn't matter. And come playoff time, this team will be ready. And as you said, Coach, they are young. One senior on this team. And he mentioned it, that East Starling Messiano has started in JVs and now is coming up to varsity. And he's a big kid.
It's true. If you want to be the best, you got to
beat the best
and play the best. And I love that attitude, and I love that way of thinking, because it only breeds excellence into your program, and it only breeds a winning mentality that you don't sidestep anybody. You don't want to look the other way.
No.
You want to play the best. You want to get yourself ready to be playing the best basketball at the best time of the year. And you and I know from doing numerous games together in different sports, that always isn't the case with some people and some teams. They would rather win a lot of games against teams that they should beat every time they're on the court or on the football field. Very refreshing to hear from Coach Barletta. That's the first time I met him. I asked him to interview when I went down there. He just sort of turned around and looked at me for a second, but what a nice man.
Yeah, he's a good guy. He really is. And let's thank everybody here, and we'll get out of here, Coach. And whoever wants to buy his dinner at the Tap House can later, as I said. Thank Hazelton area for having us here again. A fantastic facility here. Bobby Mahalik here. He's our stand-in producer. Damien set us up and he left. He did a great job as always, but Hazleton area first-class organization, and I'm so proud to be the voice of the Cougars and so happy to have you here with me.
Thank you.
And our last game of 2022, and I look forward to 2023, and we got a jam-packed schedule everywhere in Pennsylvania that we are, and let's say Merry Christmas, late Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year to everybody, and it's a final score here. We'll sign off. Hazleton area wins at 59-29. We'll see you Wednesday night here from Hazleton area when the Bulldogs come to town. Good night, everybody.